stay tuned and do like a video and subscribe to our channel The Musafir.
Good morning everyone.
Wondering where we are?
We have a surprise for you. And this is part 1 of Rome City Tour vlog.
So stay tuned. We are here at Piazza Navona. For ancient Romans, it was a stadium for athletics competition. But today, it is crowded with tourists from all across the world. When in Piazza Navona, St. Agnes Church is definitely worth a visit. This church stands out, brightening up the squares and its shiny marbles and the intriguing facade inside. It contains the skull of St. Agnes in a shrine. Yes, the actual skull. It is free to visit and the church looks spectacular in the early morning light. Also, don't forget to click some beautiful pictures of the grand architecture. Our next destination is Piazza del Campidoglio. If you have ever heard of the great sculptor Michelangelo in your history books, this beautiful place was designed by him. It is a masterpiece on the Capitoline Hill, the most important of Rome's seven hills. The execution of the plans took so long that Michelangelo didn't live to see his own work completed. This place gives a beautiful panoramic view and an amazing place to get yourself clicked. Our next destination is a large national monument of a colossal mountain of white marble built to honor Victor Emmanuel II, the first king of a unified Italy. The monument is also known as the wedding cake for its peculiar shape. We are at Vittoriano and behind me is the statue of Victor Emmanuel II, and it almost took around 21 years to complete. So guys, behind us is Piazza del Gesù.
And if you ever find yourself in Rome, do check out this place. It is an amazing, amazing church with breathtaking views.
This grand church took around 12 years to complete. This was the first Jesuit church of Rome and the overall design of the building resembles that of Renaissance buildings, which emphasize harmony and organization.
Rome is filled with ancient ruins. You can literally stop anywhere and you will find something or the other that has a lot of history in it.
We came to Osteria di Fortunata for our dinner, which is known for delicious homemade pasta made with stone ground organic flowers. I had handmade pasta with tomato, basil and chili oil, while Archit tried their famous ravioli with butter and sage. The food was phenomenal. We ended our dinner with famous gelatos, which we enjoyed almost every day for the rest of our stay in Italy. Alright people, after having that yummy dinner, we came to our final destination for today, and that is the beautiful Trevi Fountain behind us.
We had come here in the afternoon as well, but there were a lot of people over here. So we thought we'll probably come back late, and it is 11:45 right now, but the number of people here are still a lot.
It's pretty crowded guys, so we do not know what is the right time. Probably you can try early in the morning, but that's definitely not our cup of tea. So this is it for this vlog. Guys, tomorrow it's again a beautiful day. We will be visiting the great Colosseum and areas around that. So stay tuned and do like our video and subscribe to our channel, Domo Safir. Till then, take care. Bye.
Bye. We'll see you tomorrow.